Thank you for being here and laughing. So far, I don't have to sweeten it. And I've done about 10 minutes to allow my skull to marinate on your eyes. And some of you still aren't there. I think white and bald is always creepy. I believe that is a rule, and I don't believe anybody has ever changed it. See, I don't think I'm a bad-looking guy, but it's just... We see bald, white guy, we see each other, we just have a thing, right? Hey, don't explode. Don't come to the meeting next week. You're out. You're out. White, bald guys see each other, we have a sad, pathetic connection. We just have this weird solidarity. It's a weird thing, because as a white man, you've never felt any oppression, ever. But now I do, and I have to tell you, we shall overcome. We just see each other like, hey, try everything?
Yeah, all right, see you at the meeting.
It's always creepy, man. Always creepy. I take my daughter to the park every day. I can't be alone at the park. My kids get 10 feet away from me. Picture me at 10 o'clock in the morning at a playground. Really? You're already laughing? I haven't even described what I wear. Usually that doesn't get a laugh yet, but I don't need to continue with the sweatpants and the t-shirt. This head and my creepy, gummy smile. I'm like, go ahead, girls, daddy's over here. Works every time. Every mom and nanny in the park said, let's go, get your shit, come on. I saw the guy on Dateline, let's get it going. Come on, Ethan, Ashley. The gums are great though, because it's so creepy. Like, sometimes a kid will hog a swing and their douchebag parents don't realize how long they've been on it, you know? So I just walk up to the kid, I'm like, I think you're done. I think you should get out of the swing for my daughter. No? Do you like ice cream? My windowless white van's right over there. It really is. It's always creepy. I was in denial about losing my hair. You really want to know the truth. You really want to know what you look like to other people. Don't look at a picture of yourself or in the mirror. You really want to know. Have a child draw you. Right? Yeah, kids will find your most insecure quality and draw the hell out of it. You're like 5 pounds overweight, not to a child. You're a fat circle. Look at you. You're a fat circular circle. Do I have arms and legs? Nope, you're fat. You're just a fat oval, misshapen circle. Wow. Then they'll tell you who you look like. That's never good. Kid's frame of reference, fictional characters. My niece drew a picture of me, told me I look like Mr. Burns from The Simpsons, which is generally... Not supposed to get that big of a laugh either. When I shaved my head, I realized how prominent my forehead was. And it's not that I was still going to church, but I realized I was no longer welcome. Can you imagine me on Ash Wednesday with this forehead? The priest would be like, oh. Get up to the altar, he'd be like, he's here. Bring me the paint roller. Walk up, he'd be like, Go with God. I'm not going anywhere, Father. I leave this church, I have a helicopter land on my face, you asshole. Go with God. I was like, I am not, with this forehead, I'm not going to church anymore. That and God died in 2004, but. It's around November, you guys don't remember?